The film begins with the fact that we see a lot of people working in the field collecting fruits in a basket. One man stopped working and went in the other direction and suddenly fell. His son and other workers ran up to him. After a while, the funeral of this man took place. The boy was sitting on the sofa disassembling an electric appliance. He assembled it and it turned out that it was a music player. The boy's name was William. His father came into his room and asked if he had repaired the device. The boy answered positively and handed the musical instrument to his father. My father went outside and turned on the radio. They said that the clouds were heading west. The man looked hopefully at the sky and waited for rain. They had a severe drought in their village. William took water from the well and went to wash. After that, he went into his room and saw that his parents had prepared a gift for him, namely new clothes. William was very happy and thanked his parents. The next day, William put on new clothes, said goodbye to his parents, and went to school. At school, they were lined up in a row and the director gave instructions. He said that the school is not very rich, but it all depends on the students. You need to put a lot of effort and time. But suddenly it started raining heavily and the director ordered everyone to go to their classes. When they entered the classroom, they met their supervisor. His name was Chikungo. He started his algebra class. After the lesson, William came up to greet the teacher. Chikungo said that William's father had not paid for school yet and he could be kicked out of class. William was very surprised by this news and went home. William was preparing for school until late in the evening and doing assignments. He asked his mother to turn on the light, but she said that there was little kerosene left. The next day, the teacher handed out the test results. William was able to pass the test for 62 points, but he believed that it was not enough and he could do even better. After school, they went to the landfill. At the landfill, he dug up something that attracted him very much. It was a battery. William walked up to the house where the villagers were meeting. They were discussing a question. The question was that another village offered to buy trees from them at a good price, but the problem was that these trees protected the village and fields from drought. The offer to buy trees was relevant only until tomorrow. Some people agreed and signed their signatures. They needed to feed their family, and therefore they agreed to sell trees. William's father tried to dissuade them, because if the trees were cut down, they would suffer a drought and the entire crop would die. But no one listened to him. William came up with a trap for small animals and pulled a rope. Suddenly, he heard loud noises and he went to see what was going on. He saw a lot of people sawing trees. William was upset because now nothing will save them from the drought. William and his friend went into a hut where adult guys were sitting. They were discussing girls and listening to the radio. Suddenly, the radio stopped working. It turned out that the batteries had run out. The guys asked William to run to his house for batteries, and he agreed. Running home, he took all the batteries. He also went to his father and said that tomorrow he had to pay for school. But my father said that he would not be able to tomorrow and we need to wait a little. William ran to the hut and successfully turned on the radio. Everyone was happy and grateful to him. Leaving the hut, William noticed his sister kissing his teacher Chikungo. The next day they went to the dump again. A friend offered to take revenge on the teacher and break his bike. William agreed without thinking twice. Approaching the bike, William suddenly discovered a wonderful mechanism. When you start pedaling, the headlight starts to light up. It was a wonderful discovery for William. At night, William overheard the conversation of his parents. They had a very big problem with money and there was not enough money for William's school. The next day, the director called several names and asked the rest of the guys to come out. He told the remaining boys that they had not paid for their education and that there would be no postponement, so they would not study and would not find enough money. William and his father went to his friend named Travel. My father suggested to Travel that he could buy some trees to protect his village from drought and floods, but Travel said that it would not work. There was a big crisis in the world and their state will not be able to help farmers. He said that there will soon be a big protracted famine. After a while, the rain stopped completely and a severe drought began. The villagers checked the harvest, but everything died very quickly. The next day, William quietly made his way into the classroom so that the headmaster would not notice him. After lessons, William approached Chikungo and asked how his bicycle headlight works. Why when you pedal, it starts to glow? Chikungo told him that in order to make such a mechanism, a magnet is needed. He also advised William to go to the library and read books about it. William didn't have a pass to the library and Chikungo took him there. The librarian suggested several books to him and William began to read them. The head of the party came to the village. Everyone applauded and greeted him joyfully, but he led a policy against the people and did not care about them. He didn't care about the drought or the floods. Then the leader of the village got up and first began to praise the head of the party, and then began to accuse him of not paying attention to ordinary people and hunger. He was quickly taken off the stage and severely beaten. The chief's son and William noticed this and ran to save him. William's father also broke through the guards and ran to his son. The guards started shooting into the air and panic began. Everyone was running in different directions. The head of the party and his close people got into cars and quickly left. The chief was badly wounded and was put in one of the huts of the village. It was impossible to take him to the hospital because he could be killed there. The next day, William's father, John, and several other people went to harvest. It was very hot and they were able to harvest very little. It was dried corn, which is not enough even for 2 months. John came to the center of the village. There was a group of people standing there and listening to the news on the radio. It said that the government denies the problem of hunger and says that everything is really good. At this time, the seller increased the price of grain by 5 times and caused a storm of negative emotions among residents. John decided to go with other residents to a rally against the authorities who did not recognize the big trouble. He promised to come back the next day. William and the librarian were sorting out a book about electricity, and at the same time, he was trying to build a mechanism from improvised means. William went to school and sat down at his desk hoping that Chikungo would teach the lesson, but the headmaster came into the classroom and said that he would teach a lesson today. He noticed William and ordered him to get up. He told him to leave the school and never come back. William said that his father would pay later, but the director did not listen to him and ordered him to leave. William looked at the fields that had withered due to the great heat and the lack of trees. Suddenly screams were heard. William's mother said that government trucks with grain were coming, which means that they were not forgotten. Mom gave money to William and told him to go and buy as much grain as possible. All the residents ran to the trucks and William took a bike to be faster. William's sister came home and began to quarrel with her mother because of her boyfriend. Suddenly a man came into the house and said he really wanted to eat. He took a bucket of food and ran away. William's mom ran outside and saw other guys stealing their food supplies. She cried because now they are doomed to starve. At this time, an outrage began in the village where everyone was waiting for grain. Everyone started to break into the grain barn because they realized that it would not be enough for everyone. William managed to run and buy some grain. William was very afraid that grain would be stolen from him and therefore pressed him to himself. At this time, the father and other men returned from the rally. His wife attacked him and said that all their food supplies had been stolen. At this time, all the people who bought grain did not want to go outside because there was an angry crowd of hungry guys. But the soldiers said they couldn't stay here and ordered them to leave. William decided to leave through the back entrance, get on his bike and drive away unnoticed. And he did it. In the evening at home, William's father counted the money, weighed the grain, and said that he would have to eat once a day. Everyone was very upset. John spent the next few days looking for food. At this time, William never managed to catch anyone in his trap. At night, William went to his sister and told her to ask her boyfriend, namely Chikungo, to give her a headlight with a mechanism, then William would be able to make a water tray and save the village from drought. The next morning, William was returning home with firewood and heard loud screams. It turned out that his sister ran away with his teacher from the village. William went into the house very upset and suddenly he saw a headlight with the mechanism he needed. William took a book on electricity from the library and a mechanism donated by the teacher. He decided to make a small windmill with his friends and after checking to build a large one. After a long time of work, he succeeded. He opened the door so that the wind came into the room and the mechanism started working. Now this mechanism needs to be made in a large size. William came with his development to his father who was looking for food in the field. But the father was not surprised by this idea and he did not believe him. He started getting angry at his son and pushed him to the ground. He said that tomorrow William would go with him to the field to work and look for food. William was very upset. William and his friend were digging up the ground. They sat down to rest for a while. William thought a little and went to the rest of his friends. It turns out that everyone else is going to go north away from here. William was able to dissuade them and asked them to help him implement his idea. In order to make a big windmill, he needed his father's bicycle. His father forbade him to take it. The guys with William approached their father and said that he needed a bike, but John told them to go from here. William said that he could use his device to help the village with water, but his father did not listen to him and drove everyone away. As time passed, the drought intensified. More mounds appeared in the cemetery, which meant the death of many people. At this time, William collected all the spare parts for the windmill and went to look for his dog. It turned out that she also died of hunger. William's mom told John that there were no more options to save himself except to give William a bicycle so that he could make a mechanism. William was burying his dog when his father came to him on a bicycle. William convinced his father that his idea would work, and his father gave him the bike. He and his father started work. First, the bicycle frame was sawn, then several trees were cut down. They created the necessary structure from them and put it up. William built the necessary mechanism and took it outside where everyone was working on his idea. They lifted a large screw and secured it. William twisted the wires in the right way and the screw began to spin. Everyone was waiting for a miracle. William said that the battery should recharge a little. The villagers made a path for water. Suddenly the motor started and everyone raised their heads. The water began to flow. Everyone was in shock. All the residents started having fun and hugging William. They let water into the field to plant seeds. After a while, small plants appeared. The village was saved. That's it.